seasons, we laughed and cried with the upstairs-downstairs goings-on at the fictional Downton Abbey. The British series certainly served up some drama, from a deadly sex scandal to a rape and one fatal car accident. And then there were the many, many weddings, including this one between the buttoned-up Mr Carson and the always reliable Mrs Hughes. Have a look.
With this ring, I thee wed. With my body, I thee worship. And with all my worldly goods, I thee endow. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
I now pronounce you man and wife together.
Oh. Phyllis Logan played Elise Hughes for the entirety of the series, and she joins us now.
Yeah. Yay!
Welcome to the show.
Oh, thank you for having me.
You're a rock star.
I'm better than the Beatles, or you've got them on as well.
Now, Phyllis, did you know when you first read the Downton Abbey script that it was going to be as big as it is?
Yes.
Really?
No. No, not at all. It's it took us all by surprise, I have to say. I thought it might have a modicum of success, that it might be, you know, because it got the dame in it, of course, yeah. Maggie Smith. Mm. So what could go wrong with that?
It's such a sort of unprepossessing premise, isn't it, for a show that's become this sort of massive juggernaut.
I know, but having said that, Julian Fellowes, who wrote it, the sole writer of the entire thing, he had got some form before with Gosford Park. Mm. Oscar, yes. He won an Oscar for writing that screenplay. So, yes, he'd got some form, and I knew he was a great writer, and so it was just... as I say, it still took us all by surprise.
It's such a beautiful show. And your voice, I love, like, your voice is so gorgeous. Just hearing it for real.
Can I take you home?
And I think why so many people love the show, it's so lush to look at.
It's beautiful.
The beautiful Downton Abbey, the costumes, everything. Yeah. And you had a nickname for your wig, or...?
Yes, well, I'm Elsie Hughes, but I just called me Wigs Elsie.
Best way to get into character.
Yes, yeah. Yes.
Once Elsie's
so
on,
I had three different Elsies, Elsie Mark 1, 2 and 3, so...
It's a good wig, though.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I know, it's not bad, yeah, yeah.
And to find love in the last episode, that was lovely.
I know, he's an old booby, isn't he? Yes.
What does that mean, an old booby?
An old booby. It's just an expression meaning you silly old fart. Oh, I don't know.
You said it, she yeah. said it.
Sorry.
We say a lot worse on this
show. I still feel it was too soon. I think you really rushed into it.
I think so too. You know, it's Jim Carter who plays Carson keeps saying we took it at a glacial pace. I mean,
the
it was like
of youth.
Tortoises on Prozac or something.
Now, Phyllis, the show has some incredibly famous fans, including Katy Perry, Tom Hanks, Sarah Jessica Parker. Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
My God. No, I didn't.
Well, there you go.
Even the royals watch Downton Abbey. Kate Middleton's a huge fan. We've got some vision, actually, of
I know.
Kate posing
with
the cast.
She came to Ealing Studios, and, yeah, she was delightful. She was lovely.
Was she angling for a bit of an extras part?
I reckon. We said you're more suited to downstairs, love.
Here's a mop, have fun.
But we want to show you one very famous fan as well with the cast. Have a look at this.
Not Hollywood.
Oh, okay, hang on. Mm-hmm. Give me 1 second. Mm-hmm. And then you want to... That's the one. It's right there.
Elsie Hughes, what are you doing?
It's a selfie.
Come on.
Oh, everybody in there.
Right.
Yay! 1, 2.
What's he like? Oh, is he lovely?
Be still, my beating heart. I shouldn't say that. No,
please. It's your husband's birthday today, and he's watching. So you want?
I know.
You want to be?
Where are you? Happy birthday, Kevin. Oh.
Happy birthday. But what was he like?
He was absolutely gorgeous. He was not only as handsome, ludicrously handsome, but he was the kindest, most generous with his time. Everybody to a man, all the hairy our sparks. Loved him. He was just a delight. He was absolutely wonderful.
Isn't that lovely?
But enough about your husband. What was George Clooney like?
Speaking of your husband,
looks like such a family affair on the set. And I do believe that your husband, Kevin McNally, very famous actor, was also on the show.
I know.
And was there any ever talk of there being a bit of a love interest between Kevin and, real life reflecting art?
No, because if some of you might remember, he played a really nasty character called Mr. Bryant, who ended up sort of stealing a baby, basically, from poor old Ethel, who got pregnant back in season three or whatever it was, two. And he was the grandfather,
but he
wasn't nice.
And not in the stunt moustache.
Yes, that's right.
But added a bit of a spice to the marriage, didn't it? Go on, admit it.
Oh, all right.
no moustache, no panache. Is Downton Abbey... I'm on fire. Are they going to make a film out of it? Because there's
It's not been discounted. I believe Julian might even be having been finished putting pen to paper. Ooh. Who knows? But yes, so there might be a movie.
Well, I hope there is, because you'll be up for an Oscar. Because an actress whoever wears prosthetic or dumbs herself down always gets the Oscar. And you are absolutely gorgeous in real life. Mrs. Hughes, beautiful too, but wow. For an Oscar.
I don't wear prosthetics. I mean, that's unfortunate what I look like without makeup.
You are
and a wig on my head, yes.
Yeah, it's the wig.
Season 6 of Downton Abbey comes out on DVD and Blu-ray tomorrow, just in time for Mother's Day. Mm-hmm. Phyllis Logan, what a delight you are.
Thanks for coming in.
Tell you happy birthday from us as well.
Yes, I will. Let's